download the latest Alibaba's Quen model. Along with that other also open source model, how you can run with Visual Studio Code for free. So first of all, I'll open my terminal. So my terminal is open here. So I have just typed the olama command, and I'll try to list all the olama models that I have on my system. So for that, the command is olama list. So it shows that I have these models already present on my system, which are of this much size, 3.8 GB, blah blah blah. So I have code llama latest. I have the Alibaba's Quen 2.5 7 billion parameter model, and then I have llama 3.2 latest. So if I go to the olama site, so if you go to the olama site, you can see Quen models here. So you can just search for Quen 2.5 coder. So this is the latest Quen model that you can get from Alibaba. So this is the Quen 2.5 coder. Quen 2.5 coder is a series of models now updated to 6 sizes: 0.5 billion, 1.5 billion, 3 billion, 7 billion, 14 billion, 32, etc. So there are significant improvements in the code generation and all. So what we will do is that we will try to download this model, Quen 2.5 coder, on our system. So if you see the sizes here, so for my system, I think this 7 billion model is going to be fine. So I'll just copy the command from here. Then I'll open the terminal window. And first of all, I'll just empty some code here. For example, I don't want the Quen 2.5 normal model. So I will run olama rm. And I'll just remove the Quen 2.5 7 billion model. Okay, so that got deleted. Just to check, okay, it's deleted. Now I will run the command which I copied. So olama pull and Quen 2.5 coder. So I just type this and press enter. So we'll wait for some time. By the time the entire model gets downloaded. Okay, so now we have it downloaded. So what we'll do again, olama list to see all the models that we have. Okay, we have it. So now we can run the olama run and Quen 2.5 dash coder latest. So once you run this command, you can see that the model gets activated. You can now start using the olama Quen 2.5 coder on your local system. So let's try to ask, give me some project. So it will start giving you the instructions and all, just like ChatGPT gives. And by the way, like, I've been using Quen for some time now, and the responses are pretty good. They are very much better than the other models that I have tried, on par with Llama and GPT or Anthropic models. So pretty good responses we get from Quen. Okay, so the next step is that we will be trying to run this in the Visual Studio Code, that is as a coding assistant, just like GitHub Copilot, or the one that you must have seen in the Cursor chatbot. So I'll just open a new folder, or any folder, that project type of folder. So I have a folder here. Okay, and I have created a a.py file. All right, the next step is you can go to extension and go and search for continue. So continue is a tool which you can use in Visual Studio Code to connect your local LLMs directly to your Visual Studio Code. So just install it, and then once you install it, you'll get this icon here. So you can click on the continue icon, and you can set the configuration by clicking on this symbol. So once you click on this symbol, it will open a config file, and here in the config file, you can just write the models as code llama, which is the by default model that I have selected. The provider is olama, and by default model that I have selected is code llama. But once you set this thing up, you are good to use continue. So what you can do next is that you can open the continue window and you will see that auto detect is done, and by default it has chosen code llama or whatever. So here, since I have just reinstalled the entire thing, so I'll just reopen the Visual Studio Code. So just quit. Alright, then I reopen it, click on continue, then I can see that Quent 2.5 coder is here. So I just click on the Quent 2.5 coder and then I start asking it questions. So I'll just ask, give me some Python code. Before that, let me open the file. So open desktop YouTube. Okay, so the file section, I'll open this. Alright, I just close it. Give me some Python code to add multiple numbers. Okay, so once you click on enter, it will start generating the code for you. So you can see the code is being generated here and the instructions and all, everything will be generated side by side. Now if you are happy with the code, what you can do is that you can directly apply it or insert it or copy it from here. So if I just click on insert, it will paste the entire piece of code onto your a.py file. So if I click on insert, so you see code has been added. Now let's say there is some mistake in this code, for example. Okay, so I just highlight the code. Okay, and then I just press command L to add a chat. So command L, and I'll just ask what's wrong in this code. Getting error. So it shows that issue lies in the line number 10. The number list, the tuple is not enclosed in parentheses, blah blah blah. And it gave the corrected code as well. So now, so just click on apply. And this is the corrected code here. So you can just remove the wrong code. So I'll just accept. And the code has been edited. Now you can see that this is how you can use free locally running large language models as a coding assistant in your Visual Studio Code to do some task and all. And the only issue with this can be that it can be a little slower than cursor and all, but if you have enough RAM in your system, and if your system is good enough to handle the responses of the LLM, this is going to be great because you don't need the API key and all for the paid models, and you can use it as a coding assistant on for your task. So I hope that whatever I have shown in this video was useful to you, and if you have any other doubts regarding running LLM directly on Visual Studio Code using continue, or any other question related to large language models, feel free to write in the comment section below. I'll try to reply to them. Till then, see you next time, guys. Bye bye.